Okay, so that's the conclusion of clip two.
I just ask that after a clip's shown that a question be asked about the witness before we just play consistent videos.
So as to clips two and three, are those true and accurate copies of what you saw generated by Sockville Walmart employee and what you then brought back?
Yes.
Okay. Now I'm going to show clip four, ask you the same questions. that a true and accurate copy of what you were provided by the Saukville Walmart on May 21st, 2020?
Yes.
I'm going to show you. Show you the next clip.
This clip five. That's the end of clip five. Again, is that a true and accurate copy of what you received from Saukville Walmart 5/21/2020?
Yes, sir.
This is six. That's the conclusion of clip six. Is that a true and accurate copy of what you were provided by Saukville 5/21/2020?
Yes.
This is clip seven. As to clip seven, same question I've asked on each of the other clips.
Yes.
This is clip eight. That's the end of clip eight, same question.
Yes.
This is clip nine. Thank you. That's the end of 9, same question?
Yes.
This is now clip 10. That's the end of clip 10. Again, is that true and accurate depiction of what you saw generated on May 21st, 2020?
Yes.
This is clip 11. That's the end of clip 11. Again, same question?
Yes.
And this is finally clip 12, last one. That's the end of 12. So again, is that true and accurate copy of what you saw produced by the Saukville Walmart employee and also that you brought back to the Kenosha Police Department?
Yes.
So as to exhibit 1, number 322, do you believe that to be a true and accurate depiction of the information and document in terms of video document that you received from Saukville Walmart on May 21st, 2020?
Yes.
Judge, I move admission again, subject to the foundation of the Walmart employee.
Objection?
No objection on the conditional admittance.
Is there a date and time stamp on this video? Can you make out what the date and time is of this final video?
Yes. It was clip 12, I believe. It's.